Hey there. For those of you who are joining me for the first time, I'm Stan the Medical Minuteman. Welcome to the Medical Minute. Of course, I'd like to welcome my existing viewers to the new channel. Each week, I review a disease or disorder, a medication, a diagnostic, or a procedure. This week, we're on diagnostics, so I'll be reviewing complete blood counts. Today, I'll be focusing more on definitions than interpretations, but if you want more information on what each component of the CBC means, there are some great resources online. A complete blood count is often abbreviated as CBC. It's a blood test used to evaluate your overall well-being, and it's capable of detecting a wide range of disorders. The five major components of the blood that are measured in a CBC are the white blood cell count, red blood cell count, hemoglobin, hematocrit, and platelet count. These are highlighted in yellow. The remaining items are related to one of the highlighted components. For example, mean cell volume tells you more about the patient's red blood cells. Please keep in mind that the standard ranges can vary depending on your source. These ranges and definitions were provided by Lab Tests Online, a program of the American Association for Clinical Chemistry. Let's begin with white blood cell count, or WBC. It's the number of white blood cells you have. This count is indiscriminate of white blood cell type, and since being able to determine the count of each type of white blood cell provides additional information, a white blood cell differential is often included in CBCs. Let's take a look at one now and do a very general review of each type of white blood cell. Neutrophils kill and digest bacteria and fungi. They're the most numerous white blood cells and are the first line of defense against infection. Lymphocytes create antibodies to defend against potentially harmful invaders. Monocytes break down dead or damaged cells. They're the cleanup crew, so to speak. Eosinophils attack and kill parasites, destroy cancer cells, and help with allergic responses. Basophils sound the alarm by releasing signaling chemicals such as histamine. They help to direct and control the body's immune response. Next, we have red blood cell count, or RBC. As you may have put together, it's the number of red blood cells you have. Red blood cells carry oxygen throughout the body and assist in the filtration of carbon dioxide. Mean cell volume indicates the average volume or size of a patient's red blood cells, and red cell distribution width indicates the distribution of cell volumes. Hemoglobin is the protein in red blood cells that carries oxygen. Since hemoglobin is a protein within a cell, it's measured by mass. So mean cell hemoglobin is the average mass of hemoglobin per red blood cell. Clinicians also look at the concentration of hemoglobin in any given volume of packed blood. Mean cell hemoglobin concentration is calculated by dividing hemoglobin by hematocrit. Hematocrit is the percent of the blood that is red blood cells. We have platelet count last. This is the number of platelets you have circulating in the blood, and the mean platelet volume tells you the average volume or size of the platelets. After watching this video, you may not be able to connect all of the dots, but you should be able to say what each component of the CBC is measuring. I hope you enjoyed this week's Medical Minute. Please join me next week when I review the reduction of a radial head subluxation, more commonly referred to as a nursemaid elbow. And for more updates like these, come join us online.